In Mark chapter 11 and verse 24, Jesus said, "Therefore I say unto you, what things soever ye desire, when you pray, believe that you receive them, and ye shall have them." Did he mean what he said? Other scriptures that talk about prayer and other scriptures that talk about faith need to be understood in the light of Mark 11, 24. Jesus isn't contradicting himself. Other scriptures do not contradict the operation of faith, how faith operates. Hebrews 11, 1 tells us that faith is the substance of things hoped for. It's the evidence of things not seen. So I don't see it. Well, scriptures that we have that talk about prayer, such as pray without ceasing, and people misunderstand that. If you look it up and research and read other translations, you can see different nuances of light, meaning. Pray without giving up. No one can pray 24/7. Nobody can do that. That doesn't mean pray all of the time. But it means what you're praying about, don't quit. Don't give up. That's what it means. But whatever you first see, if you haven't read other translations, haven't researched it, you still always want to interpret the Bible by the Bible. And so if this scripture is here and that scripture is there, they need to fit together. And Jesus said, when you pray, believe. So other scriptures need to be in the light of that, because Jesus is talking about how faith works. In fact, earlier he talked specifically about faith, have faith in God. This is how faith operates. And then Hebrews 11, 1 tells us again, very clearly, faith is evidence that you have something you do not see. So other scriptures need to dovetail with these and be understood in the light of these. Pray without ceasing then doesn't mean keep asking for it, or else that would contradict. And Jesus doesn't contradict himself. And so I'm just going to keep praying for it. And yet we've got churches that teach it from the pulpit. Now, you know, the Bible says pray without ceasing. We're going to keep praying. And if you can pray in faith, you can pray in unbelief. And I think many people are praying in unbelief. They're continuing to pray, but they're praying out of line with what Jesus said to do and how to pray. And they're not praying according to believing that they've received it, nor are they praying believing that they already have it, that it's evidence of what they do not see. Jesus talked about prayer in Luke chapter 11. It came to pass that as he was praying in a certain place, when he ceased, one of his disciples said unto him, "Lord, teach us to pray." And then we have what we call the Lord's Prayer, but he didn't stop talking about prayer when he got down to verse 5. He's still talking about prayer. "Which of you shall have a friend and shall say unto him at midnight, which of you shall have a friend and shall go unto him at midnight and say unto him, 'Friend, lend me 3 loaves. For a friend of mine in his journey has come to me, and I have nothing to set before him. And he from within shall answer and say, Trouble me not. The door is now shut and my children are with me in bed. I cannot rise and give thee.'" Now he's talking about prayer. He didn't change his subject. He's still talking about prayer. "Which of you shall have a friend and shall go unto him at midnight and say, 'Lend me 3 loaves because I have some people I need to provide some refreshments for. They've come in their journey.' Well, he says, trouble me not. The door is shut. My children are in bed. I cannot rise and give thee." Verse 8, "I say unto you, though he will not rise and give him because he's a friend, yet because of his importunity, he will rise and give him as many as he needs." So he's still talking about prayer. "Ask and it shall be given. Seek and you'll find. Knock and it'll be opened." He's talking about prayer. The Amplified says, "Ask and keep asking." People misunderstand that. They say, "Well, I'm just going to keep praying. I'm going to keep asking for it." And yet it's got to be in line with the other scriptures. If I've believed I've received, then I'm not going to keep asking the same way. If faith is evidence that I have something I don't see, then I'm not going to keep asking the same way. We've got to understand these scriptures in the light of other scriptures and the operation of faith. If these are prayers of faith, I need to know how faith operates. And so the churches across the land that are teaching and encouraging people to keep praying without defining prayer, then they're encouraging people to keep asking. And when they keep asking in the same way, they're really asking in unbelief. And unbelief doesn't move God. Faith is what moves God. It's impossible to please him without faith. God is a faith God. He's not another kind of God. And so when Jesus is talking about prayer, ask and keep asking, he just explained what he meant. And we shouldn't misunderstand. He just explained what he meant. Ask and keep asking, seek and keep seeking, knock and keep knocking. He just explained what he meant with this story about the friend. I've got a friend that's come in his journey and I need to have something to set before him and I don't have anything. So lend me 3 loaves. And the person says, I can't because we're all in bed. It's midnight. The children are in bed. We're all in bed. The doors are shut. We're all locked up tight. Come back later. But the person wouldn't go away. So he kept knocking. Well, what's he doing? He's standing his ground. I'm not going to quit. I'm here to receive what I came for. I'm not going to quit till I have it. And so he's not talking about keep asking, keep begging, keep pleading. He's really talking about stand your ground and keep with it. That's what he's talking about. And Jesus said he won't rise because he's a friend. So God doesn't just do things for us because he loves us. He doesn't do things just because we're his children. God's a faith God, and Jesus is talking about God, and he's talking about prayer when he uses this parable, and he says that person won't get up because he's a friend, but he will get up because of importunity, and he's talking about prayer, and importunity is boldness to stay with it, that I am bold, I'm going to stay with it without any embarrassment, without any shame, without any, I'm knocking, he's told me to go away, but I'm going to stay here. And the dogs are barking and the street lights down the street are coming on and the sirens are wailing because somebody called the police, disturbing the peace. But I'm going to stay here. And even if I'm making a spectacle of myself, I'm going to stay here. It's boldness without any reservations, without any shame, persistence. And that's what importunity means. I'm going to stay with it. And Jesus is talking about prayer. So believe you receive when you pray and then don't quit. Pray without ceasing means you've prayed. Now don't quit. Don't give up. Well, I have something that I don't see and I'm going to stay with it until it actually comes. I've planted seed into the garden and I'm going to stay with it until I get the harvest. Well, what are you going to do? I'm going to weed it, water it, tend to it. I'm going to tend to it and do what it needs, protect it from the pest and from things that would try to hinder it from growing. I'm going to do what it needs to keep it growing. I'm going to tend to it. I'm going to stay with it because I believe the seed is good. I believe the ground is good. God's word is seed. My heart, if I don't ask, he that wavereth, let not that man think he'll receive anything. James said, he that asketh and receiveth not, he asketh amiss that he may consume it upon his own lust. My heart is not to consume it upon my own lust. I see that it's in God's word. It's his will. It's his word. It's his promise. It's his provision. I'm not going to waver. And so I'm going to tend to it, weed it, water it, fertilize it. How do you do that in the spirit? Fertilizer is meditating on scripture. Do you have scripture for what he's provided, for what he's promised? Or are you just out there in no man's land trying to get something you don't have any scripture for? I'm going to water it. What is water? Praise and thanksgiving. So the seed is in the ground. I'm going to water it. How do you do that with the word? Praise and thanksgiving. Why? I already have it. It's in the ground. I don't have the fruit of it, but the seed is planted. So faith is the evidence of things not seen. The fruit is not seen, but the faith is the evidence and the word of God is in my heart and I'm going to stay with it. Jesus said, when you pray, believe that you receive. He's not disagreeing with himself in Luke 18. He's not disagreeing. And yet churches across the land and pastors and preachers and Christians are encouraging one another. Well, just keep praying, pray without ceasing. And so he told a parable about prayer. This entire parable is about prayer. Pray and don't quit. That is, stay with it. He's talking about perseverance. He's talking about diligence. And he talks about a widow woman that has a desire. And the king thinks he's going to bug her. The king thinks he's going to continually trouble him. And so he said in verse 5, yet because this widow troubleth me, I will avenge her, lest by her continual coming she weary me. And the Lord said, hear what the unjust judge saith. And shall not God avenge his own elect, which cry day and night unto him, though he bear long with them? I tell you that he will avenge them speedily. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man cometh, shall he find faith on the earth? The Lord wants to see faith. What kind of faith? This kind of faith. What kind of faith is this kind of faith? Well, the woman, the king, or the unjust judge, rather, the unjust judge, he's a judge. He feared not God, neither regarded man. So he's an unjust judge, but yet he's still going to give the widow what she desires because he thinks she's going to bug him. Well, we're not bugging God. But the point of the story is the persistence. He thinks she's going to stay with it and continually trouble him. So he's going to do what she wants because he thinks she's going to continually trouble him. Well, God will respond to persistence. And when the Lord comes, he wants to find faith. If you look this up in the Greek, and I have, and even the Amplified Bible refers to it, when he comes, will he find persistence in faith? So he's the point of the story is persistence. I'm going to stay with it. Everybody say persistence. So it's not bugging God. It's not bombarding the gates of heaven. And if we just get enough people, God will finally see fit to do something because we just got one more Christian that's bombarding the gates. And God says, well, that's it. I've had enough. I'm going to do what they want. Because, you know, when it was 2,000, that was a lot. But now there's 3,000 people praying about the same thing. And I've had it. I'm just going to do it. Oh, look, they've got somebody else praying. Oh, my. Here, now they've got 4,000 people praying. I tell you what, I have to do it now because 4,000 people are praying. Now, there's a difference in intercession. There's a difference in supplication. We're not talking about intercession. That's different. We're not talking about supplication. That's different. We're talking about your receiving your prayers, your needs, your desires, according to the word of God that you know it's promised to you and receiving it by faith. Well, I want people praying. God wants you to believe it by faith. I want people praying for me. That's intercession. If they're not carrying you, that's intercession. But God wants you to use your faith. And Jesus said, when the Son of Man returns, will he find faith? And the Greek says persistence. Persistence. So all of these dovetail together. When Jesus said in Mark 11:24, what things soever you desire when you pray, you may not get it where you see the fruit of it. He cursed the fig tree, and the fig tree still looked alive. The next day, they saw that it was withered and dried up from the roots. But persistence is where I stay with it. I'm going to keep at it. Knock and keep knocking says, I'm not leaving here till I get it. I'm not leaving here till I get it. Now, he doesn't have to keep asking for it. He just keeps knocking. And that man finally says, well, I've got to go ahead and give him what he wants. Lend me 3 loaves. Well, we're all in bed. It's midnight. But he stays with it. Well, I've got to give him what he wants. He doesn't get up because he's a friend. He gets up because of his importunity. In Luke 18, the unjust judge doesn't do it because he's a nice guy. He does it because he sees persistence. Or he thinks that's what she's going to do. And I'll less by her continual coming. And Jesus is putting the emphasis on persistence. He's putting the emphasis on importunity. He's putting the emphasis on stand your ground and be bold about it. And you've said it. You've promised it. You've provided it. And I've believed, I've received. And the evidence is my faith. I have something I do not see. Now, people shop on eBay. They shop on Amazon. God's more faithful than eBay. God's more faithful than Amazon. And I tell people frequently, stop shopping. If you have finished the procedure, the process to order that, you've checked out the cart, you've checked out, you finished the procedure, the process to order that, you've checked out. Don't you believe it's coming? Do you go around try to get it another way? Do you keep shopping? Don't you settle it? I've ordered it. I finished the process and it's coming. Do you have it yet? But it's coming. Your believing in the system is what you're reacting and responding to. I can tell what you believe because I can see that you've settled on that and you finished the process and now you're just letting the process do its work. You don't keep shopping. Maybe you're doing research and looking at the different models and the different items and the different options. and you're looking here and you're looking there and looking at this item and this bottle. But then now you've settled. This is the one that I want. You've done all the research. You've looked at this picture. You've read this description. You looked at that picture. You've read that description. And you finally settled. This is the one I want to order. And you finish the process. And you check out. Isn't all of that over now? Looking at the pictures and reading the descriptions and looking at the different options. Isn't that finished? You don't keep doing that. I can tell what you believe by watching what you do. You're not trying to still get it. You're not trying to still get it. I can tell in faith, watching what people do and listening to what they say, whether or not they've believed it or not. When I watch them still trying to get it. When you settle it. Now, Amazon is faithful. They will do what they say, and you expect it to come. If something happens, you can get them involved and to start to research it. I didn't receive my order, and you'll put a trace on things. And there can be hindrances in the spirit realm. And we can go to God with fasting and prayer and find out where the hindrance is. But usually there's not a hindrance. I said, usually there's not a hindrance. Amazon, other than wavering, unbelief, but with Jesus said, when you pray, believe that you receive. Amazon says, finish the checkout and then the order is coming. Jesus said, when you pray, believe that you receive. Amazon says, finish the checkout and the order is coming. When you do these things, usually there is no problem. Sometimes there's a hindrance and then you go further to find out what the hindrance, but usually there's not a hindrance. The hindrance usually with God is not believing it to begin with. And how do you know you didn't believe it? Because you keep shopping. You keep trying to get it. Well, they said, pray without ceasing. I'm going to get other people to pray. Y'all keep praying. I don't have it yet. Y'all keep praying. I don't have it. How many orders have you put in? 17. Because I don't have it yet. How many of those have you ordered? 33. I'm trying to get more people to order them because I don't have it yet. Well, when did you order it? 5 minutes ago. And in these 5 minutes, I don't have it yet. Do I have it? Let me look at it on the front porch. No, it's not there. I'm going to go ahead and order another one. I'm going to get on the phone, have them order me some. When did you order it? This morning. But I've been on the phone this afternoon with 17 people because I don't have it yet. I don't have it yet. I went out to the back. I went out to the front. I went out to the garage. I went out everywhere. Everywhere they could leave packages. I don't have it yet. I'm going to call some more people, get them to order it. I'm going to get them to order it. When did you order it? This morning. But tonight I've been on the phone with 17 people. I'm having them order it. Why? Because I don't have it yet. In the spirit realm, that's how we're doing God. I said, that's how we're doing God. I said, that's how we're doing God. But Jesus said, when you pray, believe that you receive and you'll have it. I believe him. I believe him. I believe him. He said I would have it. He's faithful. He's more faithful than Amazon. He's faithful. He said I would have it. I'm going to stay with it. I'm going to keep knocking. I'm going to stay with it because my importunity is going to move God. If it'll move that person who's not getting up because he's a friend, but he will because of importunity, that importunity will move God. If that unjust judge is going to do something for that widow woman that he doesn't even care about, how much more is God going to do something for me who he does care about? But it's persistence and faith that moves God. I'm staying with it. God, I believe you. It's your word, and I thank you for it. I thank you for it. God, you're faithful. Can somebody say amen? Hallelujah. Amen. Persistence in faith. Say it out loud. I have believed. I have received. I have it now. My faith is the evidence. I may not see it. I may not feel it, but his word declares it. And I have believed. I have received. My faith says it's so. My faith is by the word of God. My faith is in God. God is faithful. Raise your hands and thank him for that.